Jimmy Dore, this is Rip Torn. Hey, sweetie, you're looking good these days. Look at you, buddy. An award-winning comedy special, a monthly show in Los Angeles, a podcast, and your very own program on KPFK. That's how you do it, son. You go out and show the world your hard dick. Then everyone get a good look so they know what they're dealing with. You're the tops, Chief. I've always said it. But a word of advice for your show. Easy on the politics. I'm not saying get rid of it altogether, but just add a little fluff on the side. Entertainment news. It's what the people want, Jim Jam. After all, you don't live in Washington, D.C. You live in Hollywood, C.A. Surrounded by a constellation of the brightest stars in the fucking world. Not 10 miles from where you sit, Lindsay Lohan brought cupcakes to a morgue because she was late for her court-ordered probation work. But what are we talking about on the Jimmy Dore show today? Glass Steagall or some bull-honky that no one gives a rat's ass about. The real crime out there has nothing to do with unions or banks or pensions. It's that famous people now get in trouble for stuff they do when they're drunk. How did we get here? It didn't used to be that way. One time in 1965, Larry Storch and I spent all day drinking at the bar at the Roosevelt Hotel, decided to hijack a liquor truck with sawed-off shotguns, drove it through the front lobby of a funeral home, and somehow ended up at Norman Mailer's house, where we drugged him and his wife and sodomized them with lawn darts. And you know what happened to us? Not a goddamn thing. No jail, no probation, no court-ordered rehab. Just the respect and accolades of our peers. The way it should be. But nowadays, I can't even down a fifth of Chivas and weave my Lincoln through oncoming traffic without getting busted by the fuzz and subjected to some Nuremberg trial. Let alone act like I used to in restaurants, i.e. throw salad plates at Chinamen while getting a hand job under the table from the lovely and talented Miss Mary Lou Henner. It's unjust, Jimmy. We need a spokesperson for the revolution. You're just the man for the job. Think about it, maybe, Skittles. Call me back.